On January 13, 2021, the city of St. Paul apologized for its role in institutional racism and unanimously passed a resolution to form the St. Paul Recovery Act Community Reparations Commission.
7 in favor, no one opposed. The resolution is adopted.
Treherne Cruz, the co-chair of the steering committee for the commission, says it's been a long time coming.
From the most part, it's been a very, very positive reaction, and I was surprised, but I knew when we first started this effort, we even had to convince Black people and show them the debt.
Standing at the Rondo Commemorative Plaza off Concordia Avenue felt like a cogent reminder of centuries-long injustices that affected and still affect the Black community.
I-94 was Rondo, where there used to be Black families and businesses, and they ran this freeway through, and it dispersed a lot of families and communities. And we never really recovered from that.
And that is just one of many reasons why Cruz says St. Paul is proud to be launching a commission to study reparations.
Reparations means to repair the damage that was done by the institution of slavery, white supremacy and institutional racism, redlining and redistricting, war on drugs, mass incarceration, the Jim Crow era.
Reparations have been a part of the public discourse for years. For nearly 3 decades, Michigan Representative John Conyers Jr. introduced H.R. 40, legislation seeking to establish a commission to study reparations, the very thing that St. Paul is trying to do. Ta-Nehisi Coates' well-known piece in The Atlantic, The Case for Reparations, also added renewed urgency to the issue back in 2014. Coates highlighted the crossroads that America is at, saying, quote, "Now we have half stepped away from our long centuries of despoilment, promising never again, but still we are haunted. It is as though we have run up a credit card bill and, having pledged to charge no more, remain befuddled that the balance does not disappear. The effects of that balance, interests accruing daily, are all around us." Yohuru Williams, the distinguished chair and founding director of Racial Justice Initiative at the University of St. Thomas, says he is glad the commission is happening right here at home.
I love the fact that they're doing a commission because historical recovery is key. We have to know what the depth of that injustice, the depth of that wound is here, what it looked like and how it manifested itself.
So what can reparations look like? Cruz says the studies commission will be formed in the next 6 months, precisely to figure those details out. Williams says there are 2 ways reparations can manifest.
Will families receive financial remuneration because of the legacy of slavery? The other side of that is, can the government, states, cities, municipalities provide opportunities or services? Can they create pathways to help communities that have been impacted by the legacy of slavery?
So as somebody who has been studying this, is that financial aspect one of the biggest challenges in implementing something like this?
It's one of the biggest roadblocks in the way that people think about it. It's actually not much of a challenge if you were creative in the way that you were thinking about collecting that money in order to do that. There are any number of ways that a state or the federal government could be involved in that work, which would not be destabilizing in any way to the economy.
Cities like Asheville, North Carolina, and Evanston, Illinois have already formed commissions proving it can be done.
It's a question of political will and it's a question of framing. And I think the big challenge is going to be one of really getting people to understand, A, what the roots of that historic injustice are, and then B, why that's necessary to correct that.
I'm really proud of my city right now, and I'm proud that we're leading on this effort and that we can be an example for the rest of the country too, who hasn't made that step yet.